Welcome to Medicine Woman Tarot. I'm sorry about the video clicking off there, Tashya. Where we left off with is that they see you as the Nine of Coins. So with the Nine of Coins being here, they could possibly be viewing you as someone that is like independent, financially independent, not needing someone. So they could kind of see you as that with the Nine of Coins. And then with the Queen of Swords pairing up, they might see you as something that's unattainable, something that they would want, but unattainable. So I do see them kind of moving forward here with the Knight of Cups, and the King of Coins did pop up as the overall energy at the bottom of the deck. And the King of Coins is a very slow-moving knight. It's a stable, it's stability, and it is like a guaranteed thing coming, but it's very slow. So, this person, you know, will voice their feelings and their emotions, but it's like they're intimidated in some aspect of it, and that's what's causing them to be delayed. Now, the next card to come out for you was the Peaceful Warrior Potency. So, this card coming out has lots of symbolism, and it's very interesting that it did pop out because it symbolizes you being basically the speaker for on someone's behalf. Like, this, your gentleness, the kindness of your heart is being represented by this card. And it somewhat coincides here with the camel coming out for you because it symbolizes like this patience. And this card symbolizes that you are meant to stand an ally for those in need in some way. And this may be voicing your truth or tending to others. And it's letting you know that the potency of your love is what is needed, for it ripples out far and wide, and it's time to rise into the version of yourself, knowing that you can make a difference. And it also symbolizes that while there are many who armor up for battle and fighting, this will not be the best use of your energy right now. The world needs your gentle spirit, remembering that softness is strength too. So it's letting you know to be the peaceful warrior, you know, and being, you know, there for those that need you when they need you the most. And the next card out for you is Cedar Ritual. So this is kind of interesting that this card flipped out. And this could possibly, now this is going to like kind of fall into a different part of a situation here. But it's letting you know to be careful because there's someone that does have bad eye on you or the person that is you're asking about in the reading. So with the Cedar Rituals, there's someone that's trying to give bad eye, negative energy, possibly even spell work upon you or your significant other. So it's letting you know that there needs to be a spiritual washing. This needs to be done with cedar. You could light cedar. Or you could light sage or sweet-smelling incense, you know, that smells like flowers. Leave a window open slightly. Say a prayer to Jesus for protection. And always say a prayer to Jesus for protection while you're lighting this. Because if you just light it without a prayer, it's not going to do anything. Leave a window open slightly to release any negative energy that could be in the element, you know, of your home or your significant others. You know, it might be even worth doing a washing on their home as well. Because there is someone that's trying to give bad eye. Now, I didn't look too deep into that, but there is someone that is giving either you bad eye or your significant others. Video clicks off, I'll make the other parts of the video. But it's letting you know here to be especially careful with your words at this time. So basically, whatever it is that you are trying to manifest, whatever it is that you're trying to manifest even in relationships, it's letting you know to be careful for the people that you're telling to at this time. If this could be family, friends, take it how it resonates. There's someone that's giving you bad eye. Or your significant other. So you need to basically keep what is important to you, anything that you cherish close to your heart, to yourself at this time, and to basically do a washing, a spiritual washing upon your home and your significant others is what I'm picking up here. And I know the video is probably going to click off, so I will make the third part of the video, but we'll see as far as we can go here with a timer. Now, it's letting you know to remember that the most powerful witches are those that work only with the light. So, and it's letting you know to align yourself with the highest moral code, because that is what the ones that practice witchcraft, the ones that are working with demonic energies, they lack that. They have no moral compass. They have no dignity. But that's what is going to separate you from them. So remember, always the light, always, you know, the energy of God, Jesus, is the one that will conquer the evil and will make you stronger. Now, I do feel like there is, like I said, someone doing spell work. So it's time for you to, you know, basically, you know, do a spiritual washing. And I will make.